you know, it got me a little bit excited to, you know, see some other guys, some other good big guys that I haven't had a chance to play against before. So definitely good to go against those guys.
Tell us a little bit about your pre-draft. How many workouts have you had, and how many more do you have after this?
Yeah, this is only my third, but I mean, right now I'm going to keep really, I'm going to get them all going until the draft. So it's basically going to be, you know, workout, fly out, another workout the next day, maybe two off days here and there, but it's going to be a real giddy up right now to the to draft. Excuse me.
There's probably a lot of people in the ACC who know your story pretty well, but out here for people who don't, to go from a guy averaging 7 points as a freshman to having an All-American type season that you had last year, what happened in that off season, that year, that really kind of elevated you to the degree that you did?
Yeah, you know, like you said, going to Wake Forest and ACC, we're not, you know, one of the blue bloods in the ACC, so it's kind of harder for us to get our respect. But the big thing for me is, you know, myself, all my assistant coaches, and Coach Manning especially, got in the gym in the summer. I got in the weight room, got better in both areas, and, you know, sort of focused myself in. You know, we didn't win that many games last year, and I wanted to, you know, help try to change that culture. And I think it was just self-motivation, getting in the gym and committing myself to get better, that helped me out a lot.
Like for Danny Manning, what has that done for you, your development as a player? I mean, obviously a guy who's accomplished a lot in the sport.
Yeah, that was the big thing for me when I was choosing to go to Wake. You know, I saw what he did with all the big men that came through Kansas. And I saw the opportunity to go be one of his pupils in the ACC. So definitely had a great experience learning from Coach Manning. He taught me so much in my 2 years there. So big shouts out to Coach. He's helped me out a lot.
You got most projecting you obviously as a first-round pick. What is the biggest thing that you're trying to show in this process, in the pre-draft process?
Working on my, showing that my my defense is there. I can shoot threes. You know, just working on expanding my game outwards, being, you know, versatile. That's probably the biggest thing. The way the game's changing, the way the game's going. That's how I think. Just showing them my versatility, honestly.
Yeah, I was just going to ask you about the three-point shot, John, because didn't shoot him in college, but it seems like it's coming along here. Just how much of a focus has that been this summer so far?
It's been a focus. Combination of different focuses, but that's been one of them. Obviously, because I didn't get a chance to shoot threes at all in the offense that we ran at Wake. So I think I've always had the ability to shoot. Now it's just about me coming out here, getting calm, and going out there and showing the stroke. And I think I did a pretty solid job of that today.
You're a guy that didn't necessarily have all the hype and big buzz around you as a high school guy. I believe you're like a three-star recruit. What does it say about kind of how you can, like, overcome that lack of attention, so to speak, and what does that say about that?
I think it's always been that way, even from high school to college. You know, I wasn't a highly recruited guy to high school, and then I didn't go to a blue blood in Wake Forest. You know, although we were in the ACC, we're not one of those big, you know, hyped up, so to speak, schools. So it's always that chip I've had on my shoulder, and I got to keep it there, that especially coming to the next level. But yeah, man, it's just that chip, that motivation to prove to everyone that I should be one of those guys or have my name in that conversation. That's good.